Hey there, I'm John Suskovich, and it's my last question of the week. I have an Ask Me Anything week. This one happens to be themed around broilers, but I have different themes like how to start a farm, farm finances, cows, pigs, vegetables, hops, craft beer, because I run a farm brewery. But today's centers around broilers, and I have one from Dean Nash. See, I have all your questions written down here. Dean asked, how does the stress-free chicken tractor plans, those are my plans, yes, really proud of it, kind of love it, keep the chickens from getting wet? I've watched many videos of yours and others and I haven't seen this covered. If I haven't covered it, that's what the AMA is for. I'm answering your questions this year, sometimes inside, sometimes outside, and we're gonna talk about getting chickens wet. So we're gonna go right to the cover of the book and do a shameless plug. Let's see if the white balance really works out here. But you see this right here? There's a tarp on the top. And that's the answer. Sorry, that seems like kind of an arrogant or egotistical answer here, but for chickens raised outside, weather is one of the variables. I have started with smaller tarps and moved to bigger tarps to give the birds more coverage. With the way my chicken tractors are designed, both ends are open all the time. And then there's a tarp from the bottom edge all the way up over the top to the other bottom edge. The footprint for that chicken tractor of my design is 6 feet by 10 feet. And with the way everything is shaped, it's a 10 foot by 14 foot tarp. 10 by 14 tarps are hard to come by. I often buy 10 by 15 white tarps and then fold up one bottom edge towards the inside to just make up that extra foot. And I know this is a boring detail for some people, but when you get into it, you're gonna wanna know this, believe me. So a 10 by 15 tarp and I fold it under, 10 by 14 is the best. I talk about that in the book. That keeps the birds out of the weather. It's long enough and the stocking density, which how many birds per tractor, is low enough that if it's rainy and coming in on one end, they can all scuttle over to this end and they're out of the rain. And because they're on the ground, the rain absorbs or runs off and then they can stay dry on this side. Same thing, if the rain's coming this way, they just shootle over here, shootle's a word, and then stay out of the weather. They'll do that when the sun's coming up and hitting them at an angle. If they're too hot, they'll go into the shade. If they're too cool, they'll go into where the sun is and they'll bundle in together. I run my birds from north to south. A lot of my wind comes in from the north. That works for me in the hot months because the breeze blows through the chicken tractors and cools the birds down when it's 90 to 100 degrees and very, very humid in Connecticut. We have a lot of moisture here. And in the winter, I've been known to, on the very end of the chicken tractor, tack on a piece of wood or something. If it's really windy and I know I got weather coming in, I can add another tarp in. And those are things I keep on hand that I can run out and bzz, 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 either screw it in because it's made out of wood or find some way to block off the birds from the weather. I use the white tarps because they reflect sunlight and they don't overheat the birds and cook them like a little oven. I take them off in the winter and put them on when the season is right again. You can use all different types of materials. I found that those tarps last about 4 to 5 years and then you have to replace them. With the tarps, you are gonna wanna get UV protected tarps so they don't deteriorate in the first year. Go a little bit more expensive than the little cheaper tarps because the cheaper tarps are gonna fray and wear out. But to answer your question, how do you keep the birds from getting wet? We give them covering over top. That can take a variety of forms, but for me, I want to see people with enough covering where it goes all the way to the bottom edge on at least 2 of the 4 edges. So the birds have somewhere safe to go from predators. So there's a solid barrier with the chicken wire and then the tarp. So the predator can't see through it. And also the wind can't get through on that side. And they always have somewhere safe and dry to go when the weather turns bad. Now, the next AMA is gonna be a different theme. Next AMA week is gonna be a different theme. Just stay tuned for whatever that theme is. It depends on how many questions I get on a certain topic so I can bunch them together and then get in that mindset and come down to my little photo booth and record these videos. I appreciate everybody who's gone over to farmmarketingsolutions.com, either supported us through the store, checked out some of our other content, or went down to the bottom of that homepage, asked a question, and sent it in to me because I'm collecting those, and I star them, and I have a little system, and then I organize them by episode, and I have a little folder, and then I say my 5 questions, and I can say 1 through 5, and I say, this was yesterday's episode, this is next week's episode, and that's all fun, and then I'm able to get back to you guys. I've highly systematized this year, which I really enjoy. And yeah, it's pretty good. I have a lot going on, but you guys are valuable. Thanks for taking the time for everything. Thank you for whoever you are and whatever you do. And until next time, I will see you out in the field.